मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द रेस्ट ऑफ द कंटेंट विच इज गिवन इन लेसन नंबर 4. दैट इज वी ऑलरेडी सॉ व्हाट इज क्लाइंट, व्हाट इज सर्वर, व्हाट इज HTML, व्हाट इज सर्वर साइड स्क्रिप्टिंग लैंग्वेज. सो वी डिस्कस एवरीथिंग इन द क्लास सेशन. And now we are going to continue the lesson. That is, today we are going to see about the PHP syntax. Okay, so you have three types of syntax. One is default syntax, second one is short open tags, and third one is HTML script embed tags. So the first one is default syntax. So this would be asked in a 1-mark question. The default syntax begins with open arrow mark, open angular bracket, question mark, PHP, and it ends with question mark and close angular bracket. Okay, so this is the example for it. So see here, so this is called as your open PHP tag, and this one is called as your closing PHP tag, and in between you are typing the message that what it should display. For example, here the string is hello world. So if you process this code, the output will be hello world, and this echo is nothing but your output statement. See, in C and C++ you will write as print. Okay, so print statement you will write. So here in PHP we are making use of echo, so it's nothing but it is used to print the string hello world. Okay, so this is default syntax. Then the second one is short open tags. So the short open tags begin with open angular bracket question mark and closes with question mark close angular bracket. See here, this is an example. So in short open tags there is a no keyword which is called as PHP here. All right, so simply open bracket, question mark, echo, hello world, semicolon. So this is very important. At the end of statement you should have a semicolon, and this is end of PHP tag. But this is a very old type of tags which we use in PHP, and if you want it to be run in your PHP version, you should go and change the settings inside your XAMPP web software. Okay, so your XAMPP web software will look like this. See, if you are seeing this icon, this is called as your XAMPP control panel, and here in your XAMPP control panel, so here they have given the module as Apache, and this configuration. So if you click this configuration, and inside that configuration you will have php.ini. So okay, so if you press this ini, you will get a notepad file, and in that notepad file you should find for, press Ctrl F, you will get a find dialog box. So in that you give short open tag, and if you press find next, it will take you directly to the code where the short open tag is value is set. Okay, so if this default value has been set as off, you should turn it as on. Okay, just you erase off and you just type on, and then you save it and then close it. So once if you do that, this short open tag, okay, so this short open tag will work in your XAMPP server, right? So this is a very old trend of using short open tag, but we are not using this short open tag. Instead we are making use of this default syntax as of now. And then the third one is HTML script embedded tag. So here HTML script embedded tags looks very similar to your HTML script tags. Okay, so last year you would have studied JavaScript. So in JavaScript, before starting the JavaScript, we will make use of this keyword which is called a script. Okay, so starting tag is script and ending tag is close script tag. So in that script we will make use of the language which is called as PHP, and in that we are making use of a print statement which is hello, and then closing the script tag. Clear? So this is a very important 3-mark question. So it is PHP syntax. So you have 3 types of syntax. One is default syntax, second one is short open tags, and third one is HTML script embedded tags. So here you can see an example for embedded PHP tag inside HTML code. Okay, so here if you see, this is an HTML code, because here you are having start HTML and here you have your close HTML tag. So inside, in between this HTML tag, we are making use of the PHP tag. So you can embed PHP tag, that is, you can embed this PHP scripting language inside a hypertext markup language. So that is a great advantage of this scripting language, which is called as PHP. Okay, so before and all, we make use of ASP and JSP scripting language, but in those two languages you can't embed your PHP code inside HTML code. But this PHP, after the invention of PHP scripting language, you can embed this code inside your HTML code. So this is a small example. So whereas the title is given as online order results, so here you can see it over your URL address, that is in your title bar area. And then you see header one, H1 is heading 1, so item details, so the font size will be a little big. H2, so somewhat your font size will be small. And then inside that they have given print. So this is called as paragraph tag, and inside that paragraph tag, order processed. Okay, so this is the default font size. Clear? So this is how they are embedding your PHP coding inside your HTML code, and thus this is your output. And then if you right click this, and if you see view page source, and your HTML code will look like this. Okay, so this is your coding in PHP. Alright, so you can see your HTML code here. And then we are going to see variables. Okay, variables in PHP. So variables are the storage location. This is very important, you underline it. Dash R, the storage location which stores the value. So it is called as variables. So you have to follow certain rules for declaring a variable. So that is, the first rule is, always a variable name should start with the dollar symbol. Clear? Then variable name can never start with a number. Then the third one is, variable names are case sensitive. Alright, so if you see the examples here, see, dollar A is equal to 5, dollar B is equal to 10. So always your variable name should start with a dollar symbol, and then it should not start with a number. Okay. So here $A_1, like this you can have, but you can't have $1_A, because variable name should not start with a number. Alright, then the semicolon indicates the end of the statement. See here, so this semicolon indicates the end of the statement, and then it is implemented by using equal to operator. So once you declared a variable, a value should be passed to a variable, and that value should be given with the use of equal to operator. So you are assigning the value 5 to the variable called as A. Clear? And one of the advantage of this PHP variable declaration is, it does not require to specify any data type separately. For example, in other programming language we would declare the data types. For example, 5 is an integer data type. Okay, so 10 is an integer data type. So like that, you have to declare int A is equal to 5. So this is a character. So char, character, is equal to welcome. Like that, you should declare character A is equal to welcome. Like that, you should declare the data type. But in PHP, it does not require to specify the data type separately. Clear? Then you are moving to next 5-mark question, which is data types in PHP. So this data types is nothing but, as we see earlier, you have 8 primitive data types, but in your book it is printed as 13 primitive data types. But even if you search in your internet, it will tell 8 primitive data types, and in your book also they discuss only about these 8 data types. One is string, integer, float, boolean, array, object, null and resource. Okay, so as of now you correct it in your book as 8 primitive data types, and you can see you can even see here, see data types in PHP. So PHP supports total 8 primitive data types. Okay, so you just have a cross check over it, and I too will cross check, but it is a mistake. It has only 8 primitive data types. All right, so we will see one by one, children, all these data types. So the first data type is string data type. So you already know string is a collection of characters within double or single quotes. Space is also considered as a character. Clear? So for example, this is default syntax for PHP. So here you can see open bracket question mark PHP, and it ends with question mark close bracket. So dollar x, so x is a variable, y is another variable. So a variable should be declared with the help of a dollar symbol. So here they have declared two variables. In one variable it has with double quotes, and in another variable the value is given in single quotes. So both are considered to be string. Clear? So echo is nothing but print dollar x, echo break, that is it comes to the second line, echo dollar y. So your output will be, first line will be computer application and second line will be computer application. Okay, right. So then the next PHP data type is integer. So integer is nothing but before proceeding with the second example, we will see how this coding executes. Okay, so we will see it in exam, how does this program works. So see, I will make use of this notepad++. So it's same as your notepad file. So now I am opening a new file, and then I am pasting this piece of code here. Okay, now what I should do is I should save this file. So where I should save this file is, I should go to file menu, save as. So in C drive I will have exam, okay, my exam program. So in that exam folder you double click exam, and there you can see htdocs. Okay, again you double click that htdocs. So choose here all types, and then give here string dot php. So each and every notepad++ file should have this extension called as dot php. Clear? Then save the file. So once if you save the file, all the text will be modified into some colors. Okay, see, for example, open and close tag will be in red color, all your print statements will be in blue color, all your strings will be in black color, like this. Clear? Right. So now what you should do is you minimize this, and you see the file. The file name is string string.php. So what I am going to do is, I am minimizing this, I am opening my web browser. So inside my web browser, what I am going to do is, so here I am going to type localhost, L-O-C-A-L, localhost slash, here I am going to, my file name is string.php. So string.php. just press enter. So if you are having any errors, you should correct it. See, for example, it is telling unexpected single quotes on line 2. Okay, so you go to notepad file and you should make a little bit corrections. That is, so again you just press double quotes here, again double quotes, and here single quotes, again here single quotes. Clear? That's all. Now you just save the file, control S, again come to this and you just refresh it. Okay, so here again it is telling you have an error in line 5. Okay, so what is the error in line 5? So no need of break statement here. So what I am going to do is I am going to make some corrections in line number 5, so which is double quotes, open bracket, BR, which is break, so close bracket, and then double quotes, close. So save the file, open your browser, and just if you press refresh button, here you can see the output, which is first line is computer application, which has been given in X variable. And then in Y variable, it has been given as computer application, right? So this is how you should execute a PHP file. Okay, so we will see another example also. So then the next type is integer data type. So integer is a data type which contains decimal numbers. Okay, which contains non-decimal numbers, which contains non-decimal numbers. So example, so here is a small example here which is given. PHP and $x is equal to 59135, it's some number, and var dump, it has given as var dump. So this is a function, it is a predefined function or system defined function, you can tell it is a system defined function. And then we are getting the output as $x. Okay, so here we are getting the output $x. So what does this function does is, the var dump system defined function returns the structured information type and value about a variable in PHP. Okay, so here what it does it, this x variable has an integer value 59135. So if you are printing this value, the var dump function returns the data type first. For example, this is an integer data type, so it returns the output as int and then the value. So here you can see it returns the type, data type, and the value. Okay, so again this we will see it in the PHP file. So I am copying it here. And then again I am creating a new file, so pasting this. So now what you should do is, file, save as. So inside the C program, the same steps you should proceed. Okay, so inside C drive, exam folder, stdocs. So inside that stdocs, here you choose all type file, and then here you give integer, integer dot php. So save the file. Okay, so now what you should do is minimize it, open exam. Okay, so inside this exam, I already started my Apache control panel. So here see, MySQL, these are all not yet started. So already I started this exam control panel, so it is showing here as stop. Okay, you should not close this, you just minimize this, and then you go to your browser, just you type localhost, and what is the file name here, I should give it as integer dot integer, integer dot php. Okay, just press enter, and see here you can see The value is here 59135, and the values data type is also given here. So this values data type is integer data type. So this is the use of a function called as VARDUM function. Clear, children? Then the next one is float data type. So float data type, which contains decimal numbers. So here you can see decimal numbers, an integer part and a decimal part. Okay, so 19.15. again the same VARDUM is used, so that the output for this will be float 19.15. clear? Because the VARDUM function returns the type of the value. Okay, so here the value is in float, so it returns the data type as float, and then inside the bracket the value will be 19.15. then the fourth data type is boolean. So boolean is nothing but it denotes only two state, okay, true or false. So here an example program is given. So in x it is true and y it is false. Excuse me. So if you are printing the x value, your answer will be 1. So true always 1, false is 0. So your output will be 1 and 0. So let us check it with our practical session. So I am copying this, taking my notepad plus plus file. So new, pasting it, and what I am going to do is I am going to save my file. So C program, exam, htdocs, and here you choose all types. So here you give boolean, boolean dot php. So save, open my browser. Here I am going to change localhost. Instead of integer, I am going to give it as boolean, boolean dot php. That's it. Press enter, and see, here you can see the output as 1. Okay, so this 1 is for your true. Okay, so false is automatically 0. Clear? Okay, so we will make a small correction here. If I am giving true here, 2, true, true, and again if I am going to print, actually your output should come 1 1. So let us check it. So refreshing it, that's it. So I am getting 1 1. Okay, so if this 1 want to come to the next new line, so another one correction we should make here, it is echo, echo space double quotes open bracket br close double quotes, end of the statement should be semicolon. And again I am saving the file, going to my browser, just a refresh button, that's it. Clear? Okay, then the fifth type we are going to see is about array. So the fifth data type is array. So array is a data type which has multiple values in single variable. So say here the example is given. Okay, so here car is the variable, and inside that car you have array, you have declared the values inside an array. So you have computer, you have laptop, and you have mobile. So here they have given VARDUM, and you are going to fetch all the values which is present inside the array. Okay, so here in your book the output is wrong, so you just make some correction. So first of all we will see this execution of the program. So I have copied and pasted the simple code here inside my notepad plus plus file. Okay, so once if I run this snippet, my output will be, see, I am having array, and this is the VARDUM. Okay, so the data type is array, and I am having three values. Okay, so always array start with the index value 0. So array of 0 will have 8 strings. Clear? But here in your book they have given it is string 5. Actually it is not string 5, it is 8 strings, because C O M P U T E R having 8 strings. Okay, so array of 1 you have 6 string. Okay, that is L A P T O P, so you have 6 characters. See here they are given only 3, right? So you change here as 8, here it has 6, and array of 2 it has 6 strings. This is correct. Okay, so M O B I L E, so you should change here it has 8 instead of 5, and here as 6 instead of 3. So these two corrections you just have a note and you correct it in your textbook too. And then the next data type is object. So PHP object is a data type which contains information about datas and functions inside a class. So a class is nothing but it is a combination of datas and functions. Okay, but we would call it as member function here inside a class, right? So here a small program is given, and in this program here, if you see, there is a special keyword which is called as a reserved keyword. So this is a reserved keyword, and this reserved keyword, what it does, it is used to call the object. Okay, it is used to call the calling object. So here if you see, school is a class, and for this class we are creating a new object here. So the class ends here itself. Okay, so here class gets opened, class gets closed. Inside this class you have a function, this is called as a member function, and here function gets open and here it's getting closed. Okay, so actually this value is being declared inside the class and inside a member function. So how to call this value by making use of an object is by making use of this reserved keyword called as this function. Okay, reserved keyword, it is not a function, it is a keyword. So here we are creating a object which is called as new school. So and then here we are creating the school object, that is inside the object we are showing the properties of the object. Okay, so inside that school object we are calling this member function datas. Okay, so here we are calling this SEC, right? So this is called function, and once this function has been called, it directly goes inside this marks function, and there it has been, the variable has been declared. So sec is equal to A. So if you run this program, the output will be capital letter A. Clear? So this will be little bit confused. So this object data type I will explain with it in the class with another one example, so that you can understand clearly. Okay, then the seventh data type is null. So null, the term denotes, it contains nothing. Okay, so null is a special data type which contain a single value called as null. So here I am having the program. So what I am going to do is, see, this is a program. So x is equal to welcome, and again I am declaring the same variable, but this time I am declaring the value as null. Okay, so even though first time I declared the value for x is welcome, but the second time x I am declaring the value as null. So once I am calling the print statement, that is print dollar x, automatically the value will be null, because this welcome would be replaced by the value which is null. So let us execute the program first and then we'll see. So the program name is PROG1. So what I am going to do is, I am going to change the file name here. So it is not array, it is PROG1. 1.php. Okay, so enter and see the output is null. Clear? Then this last data type is called as resources, and this resource is nothing but you can open another text file or another file inside your browser itself. Okay, so see here, resource is a specific variable. It has a reference to an external resource. Okay, so your file may be in another format or in another text format, or a second program, or a program which continues in the second text file, so that you can open the text file here itself. So these variables hold specific handlers. So handlers is nothing but, see here, so they have declared the handle fopen. So fopen is nothing but file open. So which file I am going to open inside my PHP file is, it is node.txt. Okay, so this may be some other file name also. It may be your attendance.txt file, it may be your markregister.txt file, so anything like that. So I am opening my file, my file name .txt file, and this R is called as read mode. Okay, you have two modes. One is read and write mode. If you want to edit something inside your text file, then here you should give it as W, so that you can write the file, you can modify the file. Okay, so var dump handle echo break statement. So link MySQL connect localhost, and you should give the root file, and then you should print the original file. Okay, so this example also we will see it with another simple example, but you just know what does this resource data type does. Okay, so it is a specific variable, and it has a reference to an external resource. So in one file itself you can open another file, and you can define how you should open, whether it should be opened in read mode or whether it should be opened in write mode. Clear, children? If you have any doubts, you go through all the data types, 8 primitive data types, which starts from string, integer, float, boolean, array, object, null, and resources. Just go through the example, work it out. If you have any doubts, ask me in the class, and I will again teach these two data types, that is resources as well as another one file, another one example, which is this keyword. Okay, thank you, children.